أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Dear friends, Ibn al-Tufayl, he is a great Muslim scholar from Al-Andalus. He's a polymath, a writer, a novelist, philosopher, theologian, and physician, and astronomer, and a vizier, and a court official. And he is the teacher of Ibn Rushd, the great scholar who the West is in debt to him, because everything about the Greek great philosophers, Plato and Aristotle, came to the West through the Arabic books, to the Hebrew language, to the Latin, then to whole Europe. So he preserved the lost Greek manuscripts. So Ibn al-Tufayl, he was born in 1110 and he died in 1185. And he wrote a very interesting novel with the name Hayy ibn Yaqzan. Hayy in Arabic means alive, and bin the son of Yaqzan, awake, alert, conscious. So this is a story of a baby grew up in isolated island and was nurtured by a gazelle, and he grew up and he discovered God and the universe and by instincts and by intuition and by the simple thinking and interpretation of things around him. And visited another area with another guru, and then he discovered the wisdom of the righteous and the prophets and so on. I read the story a long time ago, and as you expect, I forgot most of it. But I still remember a few things. So according to the Wikipedia, this book, Hayy ibn Yaqzan, it is heralded as a scientific revolution in the European Enlightenment. And it affected to a degree the thinking and the writing of Thomas Hobbes, who came after like 500 years of Ibn Tufayl, John Locke, same period, and Isaac Newton, and Immanuel Kant. Those are the greatest names in the Enlightenment of Northern Europe. A Latin translation in the 17th and 18th century of this book had a profound influence on modern Western philosophy. It became one of the most important books that heralded the scientific revolution in the Enlightenment. And had a significant influence on the European literature and became the bestseller throughout Western Europe in these two centuries. And this book or this novel also inspired the concept of tabula rasa, developed by John Locke in his publication, An Essay Concerning Human Understanding, in 1690. Also, the novel became one of the principal sources of empiricism. the knowledge through the senses. This is the base for the secular world and the science and laboratory and technology and so on. So it became one of the principal sources of empiricism in modern Western philosophy and influenced many Enlightenment philosophers such as David Hume and George Berkeley, also Hayyan's idea of materialism in the novel also had some similarities to the Hegel and his student ideas. We're proud of Ibn Tufayl and Ibn Rushd and all those great scholars, Ibn Khaldun and so on, which unfortunately we know very little about them. May God bless you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.